Don't worry. I know exactly what you're thinking. And trust me, it's all intentional. You're thinking, flipping heck, it started, hasn't it? Well, that's it then. Done. Flipping heck. I know it wasn't what you was expecting. And all I can say is, I'm sorry. But let's not pretend that I didn't do it on purpose. Let's not pretend that it didn't have to happen. There was no music to enhance and comment on the performance for you to ignore. No one was stood there with a wide force grin for you to flash a wide force grin back at and then ignore. All you had to pay attention to was that playing in silence. You can turn that off now. Thank you. Oh, and the occasional murmur of conversation, sometimes at an unnecessary volume. Don't worry. I know exactly what you're thinking. You're thinking, well, before we know it, we've been thrust right into the performance and we've missed the beginning. And you're thinking, flipping heck! But what you're forgetting is that this isn't just about me. Because I could tell you what's happened. But what would be the point? You're going to make your own assumptions up anyway. After all, it happened to you, didn't it? This is your story. So who else knows it better than you? I know what you were thinking because I've thought the same thing before. I've been where you are now. I've missed the beginning of performances. I've missed whole performances. I've missed whole days, whole weeks. I've jumped from present to present and looked back on the past and wondered if that ever actually happened at all. But this time, we're all in this together. This time, we can do something about it. And that's why I decided that we'd start again. Brilliant. We're going to get it back. But I am going to need some help. So, who were the last people to come in? Can you just stand up for me? Just a few. I only need a few. Last people to come in. Another couple. A couple of people. That's all I need. Stand up. Here's a thank you. Brilliant. Thank you. Three people. Okay, if you just make your way out, just come across. And what you're going to do is just going to come around this corner there and just wait there for me to give you a nod, to give you the cue, you know, come back in. And then you're going to come back in as though it's the first time that you've been in tonight. And you're going to find your seat, you're going to sit down and just act like normal. Yeah? Brilliant. Okay. And now it's up to you. This is your story. House lights, please. And the music, thank you.
Now, welcome. Welcome to the beginning. This is where it starts.
This is, if you can imagine, 1986 or 1987. Somewhere between 1986 and 1987. It's definitely 1980 something. It's definitely mid 80s. I don't suppose it really matters. It's 7:30 on a Sunday morning. Well, it's between 7 and 8. It's somewhere between 7 and 8 on a Sunday. Let's say it's 7:30 on a Sunday morning in 1986. And this is a room in a house, in a newly built semi-detached house on Innsbridge in Hull. Hull is a beautiful little city, just north east of England, just off the River Humber, just past Leeds on the M62. It's I don't know whether you know or not, because I don't tell that many people, and I've never put it in any of my shows, but that's where I'm from. I'm from Hull. So this is a house in Hull, in 1986, about 7:30 on a Sunday morning. This is, in fact, my mum and dad's bedroom. They're there, in bed. Dad on my left, mum on my right. The walls are painted cream, and the door back here to the hallway is white wood with gold handles. There are two bedside cabinets either side of the bed, and this one on my dad's side has a white plastic electric radio alarm thing, you know, the one with the flashing red lights. It's also got a black plastic film container. I used to put the millimeter films in. It's got a grey lid. The duvet is cream with pink and brown flowers on it. It was a wedding present from Sheila. Bed, cabinets. Oh, there's a light bulb hanging in the centre of the room. It's hanging down without a lampshade on. It's just a bare bulb. Wardrobe. The wardrobe is either fitted or freestanding. Wardrobe, bed, door, carpet. The carpet is really dark green. There's a window here, and the curtains are brown velvet curtains. They're a wedding present from Joyce. Really dark green carpet. Bed, cabinets, radio alarm clock, small plastic black film container with a grey lid, wardrobe, light bulb hanging down without a lampshade, it's just a bare bulb. There's a door there leading through to the hallway, white wood with gold handles, window, brown velvet curtains, really dark green carpet. Really dark green carpet. Bed. Cabinets, door, window, curtains, really dark green carpet. And I'm stood here, in the middle of the room, with really dark green carpet beneath my bare feet. I'm in my pajamas, blue Transformers pajamas. I'm 3 or 4, or somewhere between the two. And I've walked across to the bedside cabinet, the one on my dad's side of the bed, the one next to the window with the brown velvet curtains, the one with the radio alarm clock on, and I've picked up the black plastic film container with the grey lid, and I've shaken. And inside is a pound coin that my uncle had given to me the day before. And I've taken off the grey lid, and I've lifted the black film container up to have a look inside with my mouth open. Or I've taken the pound coin out and tried to balance it on my nose with my mouth open. Either way, it leads to the same result. It doesn't matter how we got there. But we're there. And the pound coin is lodged in my throat. And I'm either coughing, or I'm silent, and maybe I've got blood coming out of my mouth, but whatever's happening there isn't important, because the important thing isn't that I'm choking, or that I'm not breathing, or that I'm on the very verge of dying. Right there, on that really dark green carpet, amongst the bed and the wardrobe and the cabinets and the window and the brown velvet curtains and the white wooden door with the gold handles and the single light bulb that's hanging without a frame.
But that the pound coin is inside of me, and that moment there is where it all began.
Thank you.
I have lost it. Seriously. I've tried looking for it, but I can't find it anywhere. It's useless. It's been so long, and such a lot has happened since.
It's missed things. It's missed me falling in and out of love. Once. It's missed me graduating. It's missed some births and some deaths, and I've missed things too. I've missed the time that it was lost in a washing machine. I've missed the time that it was lost down the back of a server. I've missed the time that it was used to buy the winning lottery ticket on the 18th of March 2006. I've missed the time that it was used as a tip in Carl Lucia's on Canary Wharf. I don't think I'll ever get it back. But it helps to try, so bear with me. It's not the best way to tell a story, but it's all I've got. It all started with a journey. You were there, I was there, on the 16th of April 2010, when I lost a pound coin for the third time. The lost pound coin is lost at the green room, and Demetra finds it amongst her clothes in the bottom of her washing machine in Hume. The 27th of May 2010, the lost pound coin is found by Sarah and is used to purchase a large glass of red wine at a photography exhibition at Dazelle Cafe Bar in Hull. The 7th of June 2010, the lost pound coin is found by Georgia amongst her sponsorship money for running the Race for Life in Thornbourne near Hull. 18th of June 2010, the lost pound coin is found by Rebecca and she puts it in a charity box for young carers in Lincoln. 3rd of July 2010, the lost pound coin is found by a lady in Rotherham, whose daughter, Ruby, coincidentally, was born on the same day that the pound coin was first lost back in Manchester. 21st of August 2010, the lost pound coin finds its way down to Hersham, where Bryony loses it down the back of her server. 7th of September 2010, the lost pound coin is found by Steve, who gives it as a tip to a waitress at Carl Lucia's on Canary Wharf. And that's where the journey stops, or at least pauses. And the last known location is London. All roads lead to London. London becomes the dot on the question mark. London, I presumed, must be where all old coins end up. London, the capital of England and the United Kingdom, the largest urban zone in the European Union, the most visited city in the world. London, the last known location of my lost pound coin. A brilliant place to start. Excuse me, I said, in my best attempt at an accentless voice, I am from the north, and I do have problems with the southern people. They don't understand the word I'm saying. Just asking for a parker comes too much, so I've learned to adapt. Excuse me, I said, can I ask you a quick question? Have you found the lost pound coin? Okay.
No. No, 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 no. Brilliant. He is coming back. Don't worry. Unless you've had his pound coin all along, of course. And then I'd be worried. Lost hats, gloves, cough sweets, train tickets, and pound coins. I became so set, focused, looking for lost things and still hoping to find my lost pound coin in the process, that people became a blur.
Just passing by. Blending into crowds full of more blurred people, blending into crowds full of more blurred people, blending. It was like I'd jumped headfirst into London's river and was being dragged along by the current. And I did it without struggling, because to be honest, the view was quite nice and I didn't have to exert myself. I enjoyed being taken along for the ride, amidst those living their lives in the capital, anonymous amidst people. People passing people, people knowing people. People passing people by, people not knowing people. People moving in and amongst other people. People moving subconsciously synchronized. People after people after people. Like a dance.
Imagine if we could make this last forever. You, me, this beautiful moment that we've created together, just going on and 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 on. I never lose anything anymore. Imagine if we could make this last forever. You, me, this beautiful moment that we've got created together. Just going on and 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 on. Never lose anything anymore. Imagine if we could make this last forever. You, me, this beautiful moment that we've created together, just going on and 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 never lose anything anymore. Imagine if we could make this last forever. You, me, this beautiful moment that we've created together. Just going on and on and on and on and on and on and on. On and 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 never lose anything anymore.
This is a pause.
Ignore the hat.
It's just a hat, okay? It's just a hat. I got it at the pound shop, if you must know. You know, the shop where everything's a pound. I thought that shop like this, where everything's a pound, would be a great place to start looking for my lost pound coin. I didn't find it. But I did buy this hat with another pound coin, and that pound coin is in someone else's purse or pocket right now.
Maybe it's in yours.
Maybe you were in that pound shop with me. Maybe you were behind me in the queue and you was giving that pound coin as change. That would be a coincidence, wouldn't it? Or what if you use that pound coin to buy your ticket to come see the show tonight, and then someone else got that pound coin as change from buying their ticket and use it to buy a beer at the bar week before the show. And then someone else received it from buying their red wine at the bar, and it's their purse or pocket that the pound coin's in now. That would be one amazing coincidence, wouldn't it? That would be phenomenal. That would say this to a whole new level. But the chance of that happening are quite ridiculous, so let's be honest, no one's going to put a bet on that happening, are they? I'm not, you're not. And anyways, it's not what this is about. Ignore the hat.
This is a pause.
I remember going scouting, and there was this one time where I took my bum bag off because we all wanted to roll down this huge hill, and it had my Walkman in and all my money. And then when we finished rolling down the hill, I forgot to pick it back up again and left it there. I remember thinking my dad was going to get a spare at me. But I can't remember if he did, which probably means that he didn't. I remember going camping. I remember there was this one time in Italy where it rained so much that we had to go to the shops on a dinghy. I remember collecting my passport and going to the shops and getting money back for it. I remember going to buy some bread and taking so long to decide which bread I wanted and putting my money down. By the time I got back to the money had gone. I remember my nana and granddad coming to visit me at Cheddar Gorge and me racing out with my money to give them for the car parking, and then by the time they got there I'd lost it and my dad had to give me back, so it was all I had to spend whilst we were away. I remember doing things at the campsites, but they all sort of blend into each other.
Really?
Yeah.
Even Bert and Constable?
Yeah.
And Tipton Grange?
Yeah.
And Sandler Bay?
Yeah.
And the bird?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember not being allowed to drink orange squash when I was little because it made me hyperactive. I can't remember what I drank instead though, because I hated milk, and I surely couldn't have just drunk water for the whole of my childhood because that's bordering on child abuse.
I think perhaps it was just orange squash that you weren't allowed. Other flavoured squashes were okay. Maybe you just had blackcurrant squash, or mbonga.
Yeah, maybe it was mbonga, that makes sense. I remember being left in London once to fend for myself and falling into the wrong crowd and having to steal to survive. And then this old man took me under his wing and looked after me.
That never happened to you.
I remember going to the back of my wardrobe once, and it'd been really cold and snowy, and me and this dithering guy by that was, and I showed you around with him. There was some Turkish delight there in Bieber.
That's a book. That never happened to you.
I remember my dad making this car once, and he got locked away in his garage for what seemed like years, and then when he finally finished it, we all went for a ride in, and we had a picnic at the beach, and someone tried to steal it, and then it flew, and then we ended up in this strange little city, and then I got kidnapped by this man, and he force-fed me like ice cream tarts and lollipops.
That's a film. That's Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. That never happened to you.
I remember it. I remember forgetting people's names and forgetting people's faces. I remember forgetting whole chunks of the night.
Do you remember forgetting that whole night in the Dominican Republic after drinking 151?
Yes.
Do you remember forgetting Thingy Mibob's name at that Coppola Bobber workshop in Lancaster?
Yeah.
Do you remember losing your house keys at Neve's christening?
Yeah.
Do you remember swallowing the pound coin?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes.
Do you?
No.
Do you remember snoozing the pound coin?
No.
It never happened, did it?
It did.
Did it?
Yes.
Did it? Heads or tails?
Heads. It's definitely heads. I've seen you do it before. It's heads. It's happened. I've seen it. Now, I can't remember why I wanted that one to be tails and all the rest were heads. I must have done. There must have been a reason for it. And that reason still stands. I just can't remember what it was.
It's 8:45.
It's time for the moment. The moment is the moment that's the last bit to be forgotten. You know, when everything else has faded into nothingness, it's the last bit that you strain to retrieve. The moment is the moment that links everything together. The moment for this is a moment that will link together all of my ideas of memory, of liveness, of certainty. The moment for this will be a moment that attacks my own memory. It will confront the fleeting moments of performance. This is the moment.
That is something that will surely be the last thing to be forgotten. It's beautiful. The way it links together all the ideas of memory, of liveness, of certainty. You could say it even confronts the fleeting moments of performance in an attack on memory. Wow. That looks amazing.
This is your story, and you need to keep it. You need to hold on to it. I don't want you to let it go. I don't want to let it go. That would be too easy. Remember. Remember when you came in and found your seat. Remember looking for a row that had enough seats to fit the amount of people that you were with on. Remember thinking about the etiquette of performance. performance, of seating, like, where do you sit? I mean, you don't want to take the front row away from my family. Well done. Where in the hierarchy do you deserve to be? How near the front do you deserve to be? You don't want me looking out in the middle of the performance thinking, what the hell is she doing sat that close to the front? Who the hell does she think she is? Remember when we lost the beginning and we didn't want to forget it, so we started again? Remember when I stood there smiling at you? Remember my mum and dad's house on Ingsbridge in Hull? Remember that funny little dance? How brilliant was that? Remember being here before now? Don't forget. Remember that bit that you found really funny. Forget the bits that you didn't. Remember when the caretaker came on in the middle of the performance and just stood there because he thought it was just a rehearsal. Remember when I had to pretend to put fur in my mouth and then I actually did and I just had to carry on. Remember when I put that pillow over my head and danced the tambo like a pro. Remember when you recognised that hat from the pound shop and felt in your pocket to see if you had a loose pound coin in there so you could go out and buy yourself one afterwards. Remember it. Remember the immersion of it all. Remember when your eyes filled with tears. Remember the music. Remember when I lost the pound coin again, here, tonight, amidst all of this.
Remember when you were little, really little, in your blue Transformers pyjamas, on the really bright green carpet, in your mum and dad's bedroom, with the cream walls and the brown velvet curtains. Trying to balance a pound coin your uncle had given you on the end of your nose after you'd taken it out of the black plastic film container with the grey lid from the bedside cabinet with the radio alarm clock on your dad's side of the bed. Remember, don't forget. Please, try. Don't forget. Don't forget me.
That's the end. I don't want to leave a cue for the lights to fade and the house lights to come up and the music to come up because that means that it is finished. That means that it is the end. That means that it's time to move on. That means it's time to just remember. I mean, you'll know it happened. I'll know it happened, but no one else will. And we'll never be absolutely sure it happened exactly the way that it did anyway. Because if you say it happened, and I say it happened, then it definitely did happen, didn't it? I mean, something just did definitely happen. But how can we ever be exactly sure of what that was? So, I decided that we can just wait for a bit, can't we? We can just hang on to it a little bit longer. I mean, it's our story, so we decide when it's finished. You're comfortable there, I'm comfortable here. It's nice. Keep breathing, keep thinking, keep being here, focus on this, focus on now, because as soon as I leave you, that's it. As soon as you leave me, that's it.